Hi everybody, welcome back to another video. So today we're going to be unboxing and testing out the Bambu Lab A1 mini combo. So here are the box dimensions. So the box isn't actually as big as I thought it was going to be. So I did pick this up from their anniversary sale. So this is kind of what we have inside so far. Let's start putting things together here. So let's get organized, and this is kind of what we have inside the box, kind of like a little preview. And I believe this is the accessory box based on what I read in the manual. Let's open it up. So there's going to be all the screws that we're going to need for the setup, some grease. There's like a cable organizer, Allen keys. There's like a scraper blade in there. I think you have to print out the handle. So let's try to organize everything here. So they did have an anniversary sale, so I picked this up for $350. Keep in mind that in the US, there was an extra $20 shipping charge, and that does not include taxes, by the way. So it also came with these filament swatches and manual warranty guide. So we have some of the spool holders here. So everything is mostly assembled. So let's put it together. So according to the manual, first thing we have to do is remove the four screws on the Z limiter. So that's this plastic thing right here. So I didn't have to bring out any extra tools for this. It came with it. And so far it's been pretty easy. So let's see what happens. So one reason why I picked up this printer is it's a good entry price point at $350. It was an anniversary sale. And I've also seen this in action. I've seen the other models. And the AMS system, just being able to change colors or being able to print multicolor without having to switch filaments is pretty awesome. So I figured I'd start off with something small like this. In the future, I'll probably pick up a more advanced model. I mean, I've heard that the other models, you can do up to 16 colors, which is pretty sweet. But for now, I'll be pretty happy with 4 colors. So let's remove this. Let's take a look here. Trying to be careful. We don't want to break it. I mean, it looks mostly assembled. I think since we have the AMS light, we just have to put it together. So next step in the instructions, they want us to tighten the 3 screws to lock in the heat bed. It's kind of hard to see, but there are 3 screws. And here is the 3rd one. Just got to tighten it up a little bit. So let's double check. Next, let us install the purge wiper. So we just have to put this here, bottom of the x-axis, there's like a slot, we just have to slide it in, and then there's a screw that we use to secure it. What I really like about this is the screws are labeled in separate packaging, makes it really easy to find. And then it looks like we have a couple screws here for the spool holder base plate. So this is, I think, if you're gonna put an extra spool here. Well, this is probably for the standard spool. But since we're using the AMS, we probably won't even need that. I'll put it in anyway. So now let's put together the AMS. So AMS stand screws right here. So there's 4 pieces. It says BT3-8 screws. So I don't know what that means. But let's secure this in place. So this is going to be my first Bambu 3D printer. So let's put in the rotary spool holders. I'm going to make sure I put the right one on each before pushing it in. So I want to make sure here that they are all correct. All right, let's push them in. All right, let's see what's next. Let's put the printer here. So we have here the PTFE tubes. I'm just reading it off the manual. So basically it looks like we put the longer ones on the 3 and 4 ports, and then the shorter ones go to the ports 1 and 2. Seems pretty simple enough. And then we put them into the filament hub. That's number 3, and then number 4. And then in the accessory box, there is this wheel thing, which is for the cable management. Okay. So far, so good. Everything's been pretty clear so far. So we just have to connect the AMS light to the printer. So there's two ports. It says in the instructions that you can use either or, any of the two ports. So there's a power switch in the back. We turned it on, and then now we are going into the setup. So select language, region, and then we connected it to Wi-Fi, and then calibration time. So it looks like for calibration, there are 3 stages. There's 5 minutes, 7 minutes, and 15 minutes, which is 27 minutes total. So one thing I did notice is that I needed to move the AMS closer. It didn't give me any messages or anything like that, but I just noticed that it might be kind of far away and I should move it closer. And then next, it told me that I needed to scan the QR code for instructions on lubricating the Y-axis guide rail. So this is the lubricating oil and not the grease. So instructions have been pretty clear. I'm glad that they had the video. So right now we are just spreading the oil and moving the bed as instructed. And then we lubricate this part. And then we're gonna spread it, move the bed. And then the other side, little oil there, spread it around. Move the bed. So I do have the printer turned off, just a heads up. And then the other side. And then we move the bed again. And then we wipe off the excess on the center. And then we turned it on. And let's see what's next. So there was a firmware update, which was requested. So I figured we should update anyway. So this took some time. So I recommend having like an hour for the setup itself, because, you know, just the calibration alone took about 27 minutes, plus there's the firmware updates, assembling a few of the parts. It didn't have a lot of setup. It's actually not that hard, but definitely going to take some time before you can run your first print. So once the update was successful, I did want to show everybody that it came with this filament, which we can't use because we're going to be using the AMS. And FYI, we did have to order the filament here separately. So I had to order 4 rolls. It was about $64 for PLA. I ordered different colors. $64, not including taxes. And it was part of their anniversary sale. Should I have bought more filament? Maybe. But I think we're going to be good with 4 rolls for now. So this is just the PLA basic. So let's open it up and load the red. Setting up the filament seems pretty easy. So loading the filament on the AMS light has been pretty easy. So all we have to do is put the filament on the spool holder. In this case, we have red on port 1. We grab the end of the filament, push the orange, there's like an orange button thingy, and then you slide it in. So let me give you a better angle. So let's do it for the blue filament. So you see I'm pushing down this orange looking thing, and then that will allow us to insert the filament, and then the AMS light takes over. It automatically detects it, and it just pulls it in. So let's do it again, but for the white one. So we put it on the spool holder, put one end in like this, and then we press this orange thing, hold it down, and we slide it in, and it just takes over. Automatically detects it too. So one thing I did notice for the black filament, it did not detect the color. It's because I did not put the filament on the spool holder before inserting. So just a heads up, It was kind of a weird position, so I'm gonna have to put this on the spool holder first and then insert the filament. What happened was, since I didn't do that, it was detecting the filament as a generic PLA, not the official bamboo one. But since I wanted to read the colors, I am reinserting the filament. So just a heads up. There we go. That's more like it. So once it pulls it in, it just detects the color. So it already knows. And that makes it easier for us to pick our colors when we're going to do our prints. So let's do a first print from the SD card. So I'm just going to go with the Benchy, of course. Let's see if we can change the color. Going for red. So one thing I've heard about the Bambu Lab 3D printers, they're pretty fast compared to other ones. I've tried Ultimakers, Tina 2s, DaVinci printers, some Perusas. So I've heard this one was also a fast printer. So, and so far it's been pretty good. I do like the heated bed. We are going to test the time-lapse feature later, too. So, just a heads up, the build plate is going to be hot after the print. It turned out pretty good. Not bad at all. And that was pretty fast, too. So let's take a look at the micro SD card that it came with. So it was already plugged into the 3D printer. Let's take a look. Looks like it is about a 32 gigabyte micro SD card. So there's the cache right here. Images. Let's see what else we have. IP cam. So I'm assuming that's camera footage. Logger. Model. So these are the 3D print samples, it looks like. We have recorder and time lapse, which we did not turn on yet. We're going to test that later, probably put it toward the end of the video. So testing the software on Mac, I downloaded it from their website. We're also going to do a quick PC test. So installation is pretty straightforward. So all we have is a A1 mini. Filament selection. Alright, so I did set it up wirelessly. So since we did a micro SD card test earlier, we are going to go for the wireless printing from a Mac. So I did turn on advanced settings just to kind of see how it is. So let's add an object here. I downloaded a Benchy from Thingiverse just to test it out, just an STL. So let's see here. Let's see if we can change the colors here. So I just have to click it. And let me make sure the AMS is synced. There we go. Now I can click and change the color. Once I sync the AMS light to the printer through the computer, it was pretty easy to change the color of the object. So here's a quick preview of what I see on my Mac. So there are the different time-lapse and camera settings. Right now we have time-lapse turned off. So this is pretty cool. You can see the temperature and the filament colors and the progress. So I also downloaded the Bambu Handy app on my iPhone 12 to give it a test. This is what it looks like. So it's pretty easy to monitor the print. And I also tilted my phone landscape and this is what I see. So it's pretty awesome. Really convenient. Let me show you the app settings real quick. So this is some of the settings on the app. And once the print was done, so I printed a smaller Benchy. And let's do PC test here. This time we're going to do a multicolor print. So I downloaded on a Windows 11 PC, Bambu Studio. Let's try a different object. All right, let's add an object here. So I downloaded a poop shoot from Maker World. It was highly recommended, I guess, for the excess filament. That's kind of where it goes. So let us see here. Let's explore some of the controls here. Right now we are on, looks like we have the incorrect profile. As you can see on the upper left, we have it under the X1 Carbon, which is not our 3D printer. We have the A1 Mini. I guess there's profiles that we need to pick when we do download an object, which I'll try to keep in mind. Let's play around with the controls a little bit. Looks like this is move, this is rotate. So, oops, not the camera angle. I think we can rotate the object if we click on the color like this. Okay, seems pretty simple. So that's how you rotate an object. Okay. I'm just basically trying to familiarize myself with some of the basic controls for Bambu Studio here, since I plan on using it mostly on PC. Alright, so now we selected the object and we went into color painting. So I'm using height range to change the paint on this poop shoot here. I went with height range just to make it easier. There's many ways to change the color. So let's see here. Let's do three colors on this object. So there's some adjustments that we can make here. Let's see how long it would take. Okay. All right. Okay, I think I know what we can do here. Let's do white as well. So I'm just going to do red, white, and blue. Yeah, Bambu Studio has a lot of tools that we can use. That's really cool. All right, I think we're almost ready here. Change that a little bit more red. Let us slice the plate. Let's see how many filament changes there are. It's going to be. So I tried to keep it simple. Looks like there are 7 filament changes. Okay, so we also have the incorrect printer profile. So we downloaded the wrong one. Let's see if we can change it on the spot here. So let's go with A1 Mini. Let's double check our settings. Make sure it's correct. Confirm. And the A1 Mini does have a smaller bed than the X1 Carbon. So first let's change the multiplier. I heard that instead of 1, we can use 0.5 and we're going to have less waste. Filament's good. Let us change the scale as well of the object since it can barely fit. Let's do, yep, make it a little bit smaller. And I think this will fit in the A1 Mini bed here. I think that's a good percentage. Let's load it up. Okay, yeah, seems pretty easy. Let us send it to the printer and let's get going. So we did have to scale down the object a little bit. So this is what we're getting on the Windows PC. This is the preview screen. Not bad at all. So I did a time-lapse using a GoPro camera and it turned out pretty good. So let's remove the object from the build plate. So it's pretty easy. So one thing I did notice is I forgot to change the bottom color. That probably would have saved us a little bit of time. Either way though, so far so good. Now let us test the time-lapse mode. So after slicing, there's a checkbox to turn on the time-lapse right here. So one thing I did notice, it's giving us a heads up that we need to change some of our settings. So we need to be on smooth mode instead of traditional. So we go to others and we turn on prime tower and activate smooth mode on the time-lapse option. So let's slice it again and let's try to send it to the printer. So let's do it. Time-lapse is good. Okay, we didn't get a warning this time, so we should be ready to go. All right, looks like the print job is going through. And this is what we're getting so far. Looks like the time-lapse and video are turned on. So once the print was done, I popped in the micro SD card into our Mac. So it looks like it took a thumbnail of the completed object here. And let's take a look at the time-lapse footage. So I did have to open it up with a VLC because of the format, and this is what we got.